People just love coming down to Ingersoll.
If you like the recent changes along Ingersoll sidewalks, wait, there is more to come. Business leaders along the West Side Shopping District are ready to spend millions more on phase two of what's known as Restoration Ingersoll.
They love how the new streetscaping has transformed just a few blocks, and now they want to keep it going.
We think it turned out awfully nice and get lots and lots of compliments from our customers and people in the neighborhood and people coming through.
The view from the mansion at 28th and Ingersoll has improved during the past 2 years. Ted Irvine owns the furniture and decorating business, and now these decorations outside, new planters, flower beds, and trees, match his decorations inside.
We're very, very pleased about how it's turned out.
It's been 3 years since the public-private Restoration Ingersoll project broke ground. Since then, sidewalks between 28th and 31st are transformed. Now the group is raising money to do it again, this time from 31st to 35th.
When something like this gets done, it gets noticed.
Ingersoll commercial realtor Peter Brown says it's not only about beauty.
Existing businesses get the benefit of it, but prospective businesses also come in and think, wow, you know, somebody's paying attention here and this looks great. I'll consider this area for my business.
Phase two of Restoration Ingersoll will cost about $3 million, and a third of that comes from private funds. Now, the city has to decide how much it can afford because now the Drake neighborhood wants its own new streetscape, and so does Beaverdale.
But the Restoration Ingersoll backers say the more, the merrier.
We think that economic development dollars in the city are really well spent on this kind of thing, so we're talking about moving money around that's going to be spent anyway. So we'd like to see all those places get their projects done simultaneously with ours.
Now, the Des Moines City Council will figure out how much streetscaping it can actually afford during a budget talk early next year. And if tax dollars run short, more private funds could help fill in that gap.